Sisters, are you okay now? Are you all right? It's powerful. One or two? One or two. May the Lord deliver us. Yes, another hand is there. Okay. Microphone. Hey, if we like giving fans, pa.
Hallelujah. I believe that this last section that Daddy just shared, you know, as I was sitting down there, I just felt like something very, very heavy on me has been lifted off. So when we closed, I was just telling my friend that I saw myself fully in this message that Daddy preached, this last section. Before I came from the camp, just this Monday after prayer meeting, I was going to see one of the sisters for a laptop to work on a project. When I were placed, I was light off. And, you know, from the description, from the list that Daddy gave, the characteristics, the way she was behaving, and it was, I didn't do anything just because I was just from a prayer meeting. And so if I had not come for the camp, by now, I think that I would have been crucified by now. Seriously. I would have been dead by now. If I hadn't come for the camp, if I hadn't leave Tuesday morning for the camp, definitely by Tuesday evening, she would have gotten me fully. Because my intention was that after the camp, I was going to go back and see her. And so I believe that I have just been delivered, and I've just been saved. And I'm going to watch her. I'm going to watch her for help. But seriously, after saved by this message. Amen.
Wow. Hey. You can see the hunters are around. So because of the camp, you came Tuesday morning, you left Tuesday morning. So if the camp was not like starting yesterday, it would not have been easy. The Lord was delivering his anointed. Wow. You lifted your hand. Yes.
Hallelujah. My name is Samboligan from UCC. My name is Samboligan. Samboligan from UCC.
You have to hold the mic. Wait. You have to hold the microphone and talk directly. You shouldn't wave your hand. You can't hear when you're talking.
My name is Samboligan from UCC. Actually, I've been blessed by what Bishop said, this last section, because I was telling my friend that if you are at this camp and if you've not grabbed, you are blessed, because what Bishop is sharing is more or less like a past question for you to, it's going to help you to get the right choice to live with, the person that you are going to live with. Because if you've not grabbed and this message has come, you've got something to stand on it when you are making a selection. You will not go in for a strange woman. That is going to affect your ministry. Amen.
Have you grabbed already? You have grabbed already. So, are you safe? You are safe. It's powerful. You can't say that you are not safe. Mercy. May God deliver us and keep us safe. Last. Is there a question? It's a victory. They won't talk about the one or two.
Hallelujah.
what Bishop was preaching about. In fact, I was fully in the message. Fully. In fact, I experienced this terrible encounter with a strange woman. In fact, my name is Charles Osaibo Achidelon, UCC. As for this encounter, I've shared it with even Reverend Ogo, is my pastor. I shared it with him. In fact, there was a day, this lady, I'm in a lecture with her. We always move about. We are all in the same lecture hall. And like, I know that she's going out. And there was a day she came to my room, oh, Charles, teach me. Then I'll teach her. Then, you know, we are all flowing. She came to our room midnight. That was around 2 o'clock. We were going to write a quiz. On the next day. So she came there early in the morning, around 3-2. Then we said, Anas, what are you looking for in our room? She said, I'm coming to learn. Then we said, okay, if that's the case, we vacate our bed for you. Then she will sleep on it whilst you also share another bed. Then in the morning she woke up and she was telling everybody in the hostel, you and your roommates, as if you are people are dead dogs. When you sleep like that. So then that thing happened, and we thought she was joking. So that thing went by. Another week, she came around. When she came, we were all learning. So all of a sudden, I was on my bed, and she jumped on the bed. Oh, Charles, teach me this. Hey, before I realized, she was wrapping her hand around my waist.
Amen. Well, I'm Boedu from Lagos. I just want to sum it all up. When during the break, I was just doing some sampling among the sisters, and it looks like most of them still didn't believe that Bishop was referring to us, as in we being the potential strange people. I asked them, now, if you look at this brother looking like Pope John Paul's grandson, the Dick's Bible carrying, I mean, demon casting. Do you think that him cries? He was like, oh, I don't want to believe so. So I was even also deluded that maybe the people that the message are meant to, they are in the mosques and the Buddhist temples. Like, we're there. We are the court. But don't be deceived. We are all potentials. So be on the lookout. So, thank you.
All that I am, all that I I lay it down before you, my King. All my requests, all my acclaim, the joy and the pain, I'm making them yours. Lord,
Lord, I offer Right. Now, the difference between what did I say I was going to tell you? No, I'm not going to tell you that. I'm going to tell you something else. The eye of a novice. How novices see things. Number one, most novices have the wrong perspective of things. Amen. Number two, novices despise many things that they don't understand. They see people and they despise them. And they say, wow, you are nothing. Next one, novices think that their fathers and their seniors are suffering because they have done wrong. When you are a novice and you see your father going through something, you usually think that he's experiencing that because he has done something wrong. Isn't it? Like you see your parents' marriage and you start to think that, oh, my mother doesn't take her time at all. Is that not so? Or my father is like this and like that. But one day, you will grow up and you will realize. One brother, he was a novice. And his mother and father were having a lot of problems. But he was always on his mother's side. Because it's your mother who talks to you more. So it depends on if she's the type who will try to make you be on her side. She'll really convince you. So every time I used to talk with him, I realized that his mind was a certain way. Then by that time, he was not married. So one day, the novice got married. And I was with him one day chatting. And he said to me, you know, some time ago, I used to think that my father was very beastly. I said, why? I said, I don't know. That is how I thought my father was very, very some way. But now, I see it differently. I think my mother was some way. But it's very difficult to see if your mother is some way, that she's some way. Until you are no more a novice. You see, the thing about women is that they are easily deceived and they themselves are deceptive. Like we showed you here. Those who like, it seems as if those who are going to have the sex and they are going to do it is the boy. Those who look harmless are the girls, but they are more harmful. So it's not easy to see. Normally, in every marriage that there is a beast, the man is always blamed. The guy, Nina, he's looking, his eyes are on somebody. But that's the first deception. That's a novice's mind. But as time goes by, you see. It's not that it's the woman's fault, but it can also be because a woman is equally as bad as a man. They are all human beings. Yeah. So a novice despises fathers. Amen. And in fact, it's when God lifts you up and you begin to graduate out of the novice realm, you begin to appreciate fathers. That's what I'm saying, that the eye of a novice, when you look to the eye, it's the eye of despisement. He doesn't respect certain things. In fact, he doesn't understand certain things. He doesn't see why. Yeah. He doesn't see why. Amen. The next one. Novices make fun of others. When you see somebody getting into a problem, you can laugh at the person when you are a novice. So, oh, is that what he went to do? And you are laughing. But when you are not a novice, when you hear, you start to pray for yourself because you know that, man. The next one, novices make fun of people who are cautious and careful. When you are new, when you see somebody who is being careful about something or cautious, you will think that he's overdoing things. But you think that he's overdoing things because you are new. Do you see? Yeah. And you haven't seen certain problems before. Yeah. But when you have stayed around for some time, you will find out that the man is talking a lot because of something true that is real. Sometimes when I'm having meetings with people, I tell them, look, I'm talking a lot, not because I'm old. But sometimes old people, they talk a lot, they are lonely. So when they see a young person, they start to talk so much. So I often say that it's not that I'm old and I am feeling lonely. So when I see you, I want to talk for a long time. No. It's what I'm saying, exactly what I'm saying is what you are going to do. And that is what I don't want you to do. You are going to do exactly that. So my plenty talking is not for nothing. You understand? But a novice, he laughs when you start to talk. I mean, he does, his eyes will turn away somewhere. And that is the most irritating. You can see that this idiot is coming to perform exactly what you don't want him to do. And he doesn't know the cost of what you are doing. You see, like we have some new generators. They are bringing them. When they are carrying them now, lift it up on a crane. As they are lifting up the thing, for me, my first mind is that this thing can break. Do you see? Because me, I have bought things, new amplifier, brand new, first day. We use it one day. And they pile it. They pile chop boxes and things high to this height. And then they put a new amplifier, brand new, that somebody has bought for us. We have only one. He's bought for us from London and brought it. They put it at the top. And they are pushing the cart. That's how we used to take our instruments from the thing. So the thing will be going like that. I said, what are these people doing? The very first day, as soon as we finished church, it fell from the highest place onto the road outside the canteen. The first day, what we had. So I've seen people who behave like the most daft, stupid fools, carrying and holding expensive. And even we had a new generator. When they brought it, just as I would say, this thing can fall. Just as the generator was coming down, the whole thing broke and the generator fell down. Boom! Brand new generator. It just came down. Bam! Because you have people who are not thinking in a certain way, handling expensive things. I see, when you are new, you don't know, a generator can fall, this can happen, a roof can collapse, this can that can that, and you see them. So, plenty talking, you understand? A novice will be sitting on, here he goes again. Here they go again. Plenty, too much talking. You are a damn fool. That is why you think that I'm talking too much. That's the best I can say about you. You are a damn fool. Your head is full of water. You might as well have a watermelon for your head. Yeah. And once I've not mentioned your name, you don't have to be upset. Because if it's not you, it's not you. Novices, they feel people talk too much. And you hear them talking about fathers and such. He goes, hey, when he starts, he talk to plenty, talking this small thing. I say, you are a damn fool. You are damned because you are doomed. And you are a fool because your head is full of either water or air. And or a mixture of water and air. It's true. I say, watch somebody who says his father is talking too much. Or say, hey, this man, when he comes, watch that person. He's a damn fool. He's a waterhead. I say, he's a waterhead. His head is full of cabbage. People say, ah, my father is talking too much. My mother is talking too much. The old man is talking too much. Pastor is talking too much. Bishop. Hey, as for Bishop, when he comes and sees this thing, hey, he will start a new discipline for long. We'll be here for 30 minutes. You'll be advising us. I say, you are what? A damn fool. And I've not mentioned your name. So you can just escape from it. You are a waterhead. And it is your inexperience that makes you think that way. It's amazing. So try to graduate. And you see, you can just hear people talking. Hey, this guy. You say, hey, don't let him see this. When he sees it now, we will be here. Give us a lecture on grass. How this grass comes, this, water. This is this man. Now I'm this man. You are a damn fool. I'm looking for you. That's why I'm calling you out like that. Can't say, why have they locked the doors? Have they locked the doors? Say, as for this man, you come, you bring a maid talking so much, this. Because I have been in the church. We'll be in the church, you see that money will get missing in the office. We have been in the church, we see tape copiers. Whole tape copiers will vanish from the church. They say, I am coming to talk too much. You are a damn fool with the water. You are a waterhead or orange juice in your head. That is what you see. I'm searching for you hard in the congregation to see where you are. That I'm talking to. So watch out for people who talk that way. It's a sign that you are in the presence of a novice. Yeah. I've worked with architects who, one day, can you imagine a building which has a column like this, on top of which is coming the roof. And one day there was a rain, not a storm, it rained. Not a rainstorm, not this type of storm that we've been having. I'm talking about rain. And the columns, built by an architect, came down like this. Something that has been cast with concrete. Wind can blow it down. It's standing on its own. With iron rods and concrete. I sacked that architect and his company on that day. I said, out. And I can take you around the site and show you things that he did that made the whole place crooked. So when I come around, I'll be saying, hey, you have to do this. And they'll be looking at you. And you see them as if you are talking a lot. This is talking too much. But I've seen it before. And when the thing falls down, they will not say architecture. So they'll say, lighthouse, bishop, this is ambitious building. This is so necessary. This, the thing has fallen down, has killed people. And they will not mention you. They'll mention me. That's why I want to eject all the damn fools. Ask the person next to you, are you one of the damn fools? He is not talking too much. She is not talking too much. They are not talking too much. Even when your father is advising you against full-time ministry, he's not talking too much. He knows what he's saying. You understand? He knows what he's saying. He has seen people like me before who didn't end up well, that people followed. He has seen just somebody just like me before. So as he's speaking the very good advice. That's your test, whether you follow it or not. That one I can't tell you. But I can tell you, your father is not a fool. If you don't know, your father is never a fool. And your mother is not a fool. They are not fools. People are not fools. You are the fool. Yeah, they are not talking too much. What they are saying is true. Yeah. They are not talking too much. What they are saying is true. You don't have to despise them. Say, hey, my mother is a prostitute. She's a backslider. This and that. She's not. Don't talk like that about your mother. Don't talk like that. Even if you want to serve God, don't talk like that. What she's saying, she has seen something. Maybe your mother has slept with a pastor before. But she can't tell you. Maybe your mother is a strange woman. And she can't say it to you. So she may be saying something, but you don't know. She has also worked in a church before. Or slept with a priest. Or different. You don't know. Even you cry. You don't know your father, your real father. You don't know. So as she's advising against the church, you don't know why. And these old ladies with their cloth and so on. You don't know how many men they have slept with. I see them holding, singing. Our God, I have been ages past. I hope for years to come. A shelter from the stormy blast and our eternal hope. Amen. One day a young boy, he said, watch me. There was a lady from a church. These churches. Born again church. Not a, don't think of a bad church. Think of a good church. He said, I'm going to sleep with her. Somebody's wife, a young boy, said, I'm going to sleep with her. He said, come and look at it. I know the person. And he called his friend to come back. He came to stand outside the window. And he slept with the elderly woman. And after she wore her cloth and went to service in the evening, she was wearing her cloth. She went to the church, singing with white handkerchief and then. He saw it with his eyes. And elderly women, they like young men. And they like young men with hard penises. you don't like my message, you see. Because the old ones are not working that way. So as she is saying, she has slept with some pastors before. And she's advising you so that you don't go that way and they end up also sleeping. But she can't say it. No mother is a fool. No father is a fool. Don't speak like a novice anymore. When fathers and mothers, there are reasons for things. Things don't go the way you think they may go. Sometimes it goes like this and it swerves. Yeah. So don't. Even if you want to obey God, and you, God has called you to the ministry and you want to serve Him, there is a way you handle the fathers and the mothers. Say, Daddy, I know what you are saying is true. But I sense that God has called me. And this is what I really want to do. But I know that you are a fool. Or not that you are a backslider. I'm sure what you are saying is out of love. When Peter told Jesus, you will not die on the... It was out of his love for Jesus. But it was still Satan speaking. It was very good advice. But it was satanic. Look, if you are feeling sleepy, put up your hand so that you can come and stand in front here. Okay, I'm giving you a chance. If you are feeling sleepy, you get up and go to the back. If I see you sleeping, you come to the front. And I'm going to use this front row as the policeman to go and retrieve you. So, should in case you are feeling sleepy, to the back, right away. Because I haven't finished preaching at all. 4 a.m. and then we are closing. So, that's it. The next one. A novice makes fun of, what did I say? Of fathers. Next one. A novice makes fun of prophets. When a prophet is saying something that is going to happen, they laugh. Because they haven't seen it before. That somebody can say something to happen. The next one is novices make fun of poor people. You know, sometimes when somebody is in an unfortunate situation, they will ask you, do you give tithes? Do you pay tithes? Do you give special offerings? Do you work hard? Are you diligent? And you ask the person, have you seen that scripture? It said that, see thou a man that is diligent in his business, he shall stand before kings. If you were diligent, you would have been standing before kings. Yeah. When you are young, I know people who are very hardworking in Mexico. Just across, they work from morning to evening. Harder than the people in America across the border. And they are very poor. You say it's hard work. Do you work hard? I know a lot of people who work hard and they are very poor. Does anybody here know somebody who works very hard and is still very poor? Yeah. A lot of people work very... It's not only hard work that makes somebody rich. They work from morning to evening, carrying firewood, doing this, that, killing snakes, doing all sorts of things, and they are still poor. It is when you are young that you look at somebody in a circumstance and say, you damn fool, if you were diligent, you will not be in this situation. But what you don't know is that if you were born in a certain village, it's almost impossible to ever have anything till you die. You cannot break out. Even you cannot speak English. It's not because you are not diligent. They are very, very diligent. But I have somebody who worked for me. He's a very, very clever person. Very intelligent. But we found him on the streets. We found him. He was used to sell dog chains on the street like that. Selling dog chains. But he's very clever. Maybe from the background that he had, that is where he could end up. Yeah, but he's a very, very clever person. More clever than a lot of people who've been to school. Yeah. But that's where he was selling chains. 2,000 and come with a car. With a car. 2,000 dog chains. He's very clever. I trust him more than most of you here. But that's it's not that he's not hardworking. He said, do you work hard? If you were hardworking, you would not be here. It's not true. When you are young, that is how you will think. Why are you sick? Do you do exercise? You've been exercising. Why are you overweight? You shouldn't eat chicken. Don't eat rice. Don't drink malt. Don't drink water. Don't do this. Don't do this. Did I notice your eyes closing? It was not you. I'm not sure that is why. Was it because there's a shadow on you? All right. His eyes were closed. Because I want to get some people in front here to guard me. You say that I'm talking too much. Too much talking. Job chapter 13 verse 9. Is it good that he should search you out? Or as one that mocketh another, do you so mock him? Job 39 verse 22. He mocketh at fear and is not affrighted, neither turneth he back from the sword. This is a novice. Proverbs 17 verse 5. Whoso mocketh the poor reproacheth his maker, and he that is glad at calamity shall not go unpunished. You are mocking poor people. You are mocking poor people. You will not go unpunished. And when you mock the poor, you are reproaching your maker. Don't despise me because I don't have money. The eye that mocketh at his father and despiseth to obey his mother, the ravens of the valley shall pick it out, and the young eagles shall eat it. Proverbs 30 verse 17. You think your father is talking too much. One day a certain man, he called his son and told him, I want to give you some advice for marriage. He said, I have only one advice to give you. He said, what is that? And he said, never marry a virgin. Hey! That is all that he said. He said, never marry a virgin. Within that statement, you have to think, because that is all that he said. What does it mean? And why did he say that? He said, daddy is a fool. Daddy is a fool. I know somebody, they used to look down on their father. So, but daddy is useless. Daddy doesn't bring money. It's mommy who looks after us. Then one day, an uncle came to the house, and there was a whole big trouble. And the uncle called the daughter aside and said, look, you have to know the truth about your mother. Your mother is a prostitute. It is the biggest problem in this house for years. It's a known thing. She goes here, she sleeps. A real person, I know the person. She sleeps with this, she goes with this big person, she sleeps with this. That is how she gets money. And she's always saying, daddy is a fool, daddy is this, daddy is that. And in their eyes, their daddy has always been a fool. That's why I said, don't despise any of them. You don't know the details. And it is a novice who looks down on people, especially such elderly people. That's why I honor Bishop Duncan Williams. And I pray that I will always honor him, no matter what. Somebody who has been to prison before, because of Christ. Somebody whose head has been shaved before by revolutionary guards. They shaved his head completely. He wore a hat to church on Sunday. He wore a hat and came to church. Somebody who has fought for all of us to be on television today in Ghana would not have been on television. I should say that what? You don't know what somebody has been through to make it possible for you to also be around. Are you there? Oh Lord, thou hast deceived me. I was deceived. Thou art stronger than I and hast prevailed. I am in derision daily. Everyone mocketh me. Amen. So the eye of a novice, it's an eye of despisement. It's an eye which does not understand why somebody is talking, what he is saying, and you don't understand it, and you want to fight him. That is the eye of an inexperienced person. Have you locked the door? Too much locking. You are new. You are new. Why are we passing there in the night? Too much. Because I've passed there in the night to see things. And I've seen amazing things. Amazing. Are you there? Yeah. So may your eye from today not be the eye of a novice, but the eye of someone who understands fathers, prophets, mothers, and all these elderly people who seem to talk a lot. Rather, become someone who can relate with them. When they talk, we know that they know they are talking to a wise son or a wise daughter. And you will see that God will bless you. Amen. Stand to your feet, everybody. Lift your hands up. Thank the Lord. Oh, Jesus. Father, we thank you. We praise you. We give you honor. We give you glory. We give you praise. Thank you, Jesus. We love you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen.